potted landscapes emerged as an art in the Qing court after 1727, produced by the imperial workshops. These landscapes are often composed of gold and silver, pearl, jade, corals, or agate, among other precious materials. This potted landscape is 41.5 centimeters tall and 33 centimeters long. It depicts the paradise of the immortals. Its upper half counts 679 rubies, 183 sapphires, and 332 tourmalines. In Chinese traditional culture, the paradise of immortals is a mythical island where all the sacred immortals live. We thus see the island saturated with rubies and precious stones, amidst which the god of longevity have been carved in jade, with a small child holding a ruby scepter in his hand to the left, while to the right stands a red-crowned crane with a pearl on its back. This potted landscape subject is also the paradise of immortals, despite the marked differences that exist between them and the depiction that we have just seen. The island is also carved in malachite with pearls of each color as ornaments. The god of longevity has been carved in white jade as the focal point of the piece. In a composition that is tastefully simple, its human depictions lifelike and fresh. Potted landscapes stress the ingenuity of craftsmanship. Such is the case with this landscape depicting Ma Gu, the Taoist nun protector of the old. Its author has cleverly made good use of the coral's original shape to carve out this phoenix with wings stretched, seemingly ready to take flight. According to the Qing Dynasty Palace records, this potted landscape was mainly used as a congratulatory image on the Empress's birthday. It is 37 centimeters tall and depicts Ma Gu standing on the phoenix's back holding a tourmaline peach in her hand, the symbol of longevity. As a material easily carved with a bright and beautiful color, the use of red coral in potted landscapes became widely popularized during the Qing Dynasty. This is a potted landscape wishing for happiness and abundance in red coral and jade, a masterpiece of coral potted landscape from the late Qing Dynasty. Red is fire in the hands of an able artisan. The coral has been turned into a goldfish, which hangs upon a coral tree, the red and green colors complementing each other in a magnificent display of beauty. However, it was not only the imperial workshop which produced potted landscapes, since in Yangzhou, Guangzhou, and Suzhou, their productions as gifts expressing congratulations and good wishes became widespread. This natural wood carved and jade carved potted landscape comes from a Suzhou workshop. It is evident at first glance that it is nowhere as extravagant as the works of the Forbidden City. Its style is fresh and refined, exuding the charm of the famous Suzhou gardens famed for their beauty. It is said that this potted landscape of 73 centimeters in height was an imperial favorite. Its base is made of rosewood, while on its mountains we find white jade, agate, emerald, and tourmalines that have been carved onto Ganoderma's and immortal peaches. In the middle of the mountain we find seven old immortals standing, some of them walking together, others seated engaged in idle conversation. A jade crane holds immortal herbs in its beak and is hung, flying on the mountain peak, while a jade deer lies down next to the striking pavilion. It is indeed a work of spellbinding beauty.